Hello, I'm Dr. Beasley, Superintendent of Schools. I am so excited to congratulate our first round of employee and alumni who are being spotlighted. Why are they being spotlighted? Because they are so reflective of a culture of high performance. And so to all of you employees and alumni that are being spotlighted on this first round, we'd like to say congratulations to you. Thank you for being a model of what high performance actually is and what it looks like. And to you employees and alumni who are out there, walk in excellence, reflect a culture of high performance, and you never know, someone may be recommending you to be one of the persons that we spotlight as an employee or alumni that reflects high performance. So again, congratulations to those that are being honored, that are being highlighted, that are being spotlighted, and for those who wish to be highlighted and spotlighted, keep up the great work. Continue on the path of high performance. Congratulations.
My name is Michael Montana. I attended Mara High School. I graduated in 06. I'm a Mustang. Right now, I am a music artist. I do music. I've been doing music for 10 years. My first song was Do It, featuring K-Camp. I'm still on the road right now, currently doing shows. I have a tour coming up, HBCU tour. Right now, I'm speaking with the kids. You know what I'm saying? I'm going throughout different colleges, schools, elementary, middle schools, and, you know, spread my love and my genuine support back to them. Yeah, I got crowned homecoming king at Mara High School. I think we played Lovejoy High School. I had got like 3-4 touchdowns, you know what I'm saying, that night, man. I played like Deion Sanders that night in his prime, man, you know what I'm saying? Thankful, you know, it's amazing to just even be thought of like in your country, in your town, in your county, in your state. Like, you know what I'm saying? That means a lot because nowadays they got a thing where they try to put a lifespan on artists where they, you know, don't feel as if we're gonna see, you know, when we was younger, they say we might not live past 18, you know, and then once you get in the music industry business, they see, you know, they say, you know, artists don't live well, but I feel like I can be a very example of artists that can do more than just rap, you know what I'm saying? We can go spread the word to the youth, you know, give the youth a chance, you know what I'm saying, to get their word to the people, you know what I'm saying? Let them know they ain't just bad, they ain't just young, you know what I'm saying? They're just misguided, you know what I'm saying? And people like me that understand where they're coming from, you know what I'm saying? We don't try to too much put the blame on them. We just try to embrace them, help them, you know what I'm saying? Give them knowledge, give them things that I never was getting as a child, you know what I'm saying? And we try to spread that to the kids, spread it to the parents, you know what I'm saying? Plant seeds with an adult so everybody around can be on the same type of token so we can all spread it and it'd be a great disease pulling around, moving around. Don't stop going. Don't stop believing. Don't stop praying. Think big at all times, you know what I'm saying? Believe you can go further. Support your community, support your people, be there for them. Everything don't cost money, you know what I'm saying? Time, go talk to your people, you know what I'm saying? If you care about the youth, you care about yourself, you know what I'm saying? You don't want other things going on and attacking your youth, man, you know what I'm saying? Embrace the people around you, plant good seeds, and let's keep going, man, let's keep going. God is good, Michael Montana, thankful. Thank you for having me.
My name is Nia Donaldson, and I graduated from Lovejoy High School, class of 2001. I am currently the owner of the Movement Dance Studio located in downtown Jonesboro. I have been the owner for the Movement Dance Studio for 7 years. We teach dance. I am the only full ballroom studio in Atlanta that is black owned. I teach waltz, foxtrot, rumba, tango, salsa, bachata. I teach ballet, tap, hip hop. We have a staff. We have community events. We have many things that we do in the area, 2 recitals, Nutcracker festivals, fall festivals, many things that we do in the area, right off of Main Street. My greatest memory of Clayton County Public Schools, I would have to say, cannot be summed up into one memory. It would have to be the people. I love my classmates. I loved and enjoyed my teachers. Everything that they gave me, I still use to this day. I love the friends that I develop. Luckily, we have platforms now that we can use to keep in touch, even though we don't see each other every day, even though a lot of us are spread out throughout the country and the world. I really have to say I enjoyed laughing, hanging out. I would have to say parking lot hangout, Live Oak Stadium, games, just enjoying, the games, football games, basketball games, just enjoying hanging out with our friends. Oh my goodness, I feel so grateful and so loved that I was nominated for being a contributor to Clayton County Public School System and Clayton County in general. I have been working and living in Clayton County for a very long time. So for someone to think of me it's emotional, you know, to know that somebody loves you enough to nominate you. So I'm very grateful. With everything that's going on in the world, at a point where you're starting to question, what are you doing? How long do I want to do this? Am I valuable? Am I contributing? And even though my name is Nia, and it means purpose, and it's the fifth principle of Kwanzaa, so it means to give to your community, and it means to give back. And I was starting to question if I'm starting to do things. So this nomination definitely told me and affirmed that I am on the right path. And I believe that I'm going to keep moving forward and keep putting more into my community.
I'm Dr. Jamie Johnson Duplessis. I attended Morrow High School and I graduated in 2008. My current occupation is Director of Fellow Experience at a nonprofit, and I'm also an education entrepreneur. My greatest memory is actually being in English class and specifically working with a teacher named Keisha Poole, who encouraged me to share my voice and to express myself through writing, using poetry slams, and then also connecting the literature to my culture as a Black woman. And so I was so excited to finally feel belonging in a school when I started coming to Morrow High School after Hurricane Katrina. It definitely feels great because sometimes I'm doing so much that I forget, you know, like what the impact that I may be having. And I'm realizing, you know, since I've come back to stay in Clayton County, have my kids in the school system, et cetera, that like the work that I'm doing is still going, is noticed. I feel like I've been getting a lot of recognition when it comes to Clayton County. That's when I first really came to my own, and it's continuing to show that in adulthood. I would just say this is a great honor. Like I said, I came here in 2005 after Hurricane Katrina, and I refused to leave because of the belongingness that I felt being in the high school, at Morrow High School in Clayton County. And so I moved back because I wanted to raise my children with that same sense of belonging, that same sense of inclusion, and just excellence. I feel like Clayton County Public Schools breeds a level of excellence that's worth handing on to your children and people in your family.
My name is Luana Rantall, and I attended North Clayton High School. I graduated in the class of 1994. I'm currently a partner at the law firm of Smith, Welch, Webb & White down in McDonough. We have several locations. However, I've been a practicing attorney since 2020. Ooh, God, I'm in 2001. Oh gosh, I just remember a really great sense of family, a great sense of support, a great sense of community. I grew up in Clayton County ever since I was a small child. We've attended elementary school here, middle school. I served with a lot of civic organizations. There was just a lot of opportunity for us to really thrive in the Clayton County school system and opportunities that we were given. I feel that is one of the highest honors that I could have. I service, of course, our law firm, we represent school districts, but I personally worked with Clayton County as a judicial law clerk for 12 years. So I'm used to serving the community with regards to that in my legal service. But I also appreciate and understand the importance of education. Again, I do educational law, so I'm in the school buildings. I see the challenges that a lot of our educational systems and our districts are facing. And I just appreciate the opportunity to represent Clayton County in my everyday capacity as an attorney, as well as this great honor that I've been given.
My name is Melissa McMichael, and I'm a custodian at River's Edge Elementary. I have been working at River's Edge for 9 years. I am honored to be nominated for this spotlight. All I know is that I go to work every day to do my job to the best of my ability, because I have this saying that when I leave it, my name is left on it. So I'm honored that they even recognize what I do every day on a day-to-day basis. I enjoy what I do. I go to work every day looking forward to go to work and to interact with the kids and all of my fellow workers. I love working at River's Edge.
Hello, my name is Melanie Connor. I am the proud servant leader of Sequoia Middle School. I've been an educator in Clayton County Public Schools since 2005. I started my career with Clayton County at Mundy's Mill High School. I then matriculated to Riverdale High School, Lovejoy High School, Morrow High School, and now I'm the proud principal of Sequoia Middle. I'm honored, I'm most humbled, and I'm grateful to be nominated for this spotlight. I think that as a principal, in my seventh year, a lot of times we are doing the work and we're doing the work and we're making sure that everyone else is okay and everyone else is acknowledged. And oftentimes, sometimes, you know, we don't know if our work is being seen or we're adding true value, although we know we're doing that. It's good to hear those that we serve every day, from our teachers to our parents to our scholars and our school community at large, to just reaffirm that the work that we're doing matters, because we are doing a great work from which we cannot come down. I just like to say a special thank you to the persons that nominated me, particularly those that are on my staff. I love our Warrior Nation community at large, and I know that the work that we do is done well as we do it together. So I thank my staff members. I thank the district for having this recognition. It's truly something special to be honored in this way. And so I just want to make certain that those who thought of me and my servant leadership was worthy of this nomination. I want to say thank you for all you do and what's best for children, not only at Sequoia Middle School, but in Clayton County Public Schools.
My name is Dr. Felicia Brown. I am a school psychologist in Clayton County Public Schools, and I am based in central office, but I also serve 3 schools. I have been a school psychologist in Clayton County Public Schools for 9 years. I feel honored to be nominated for the CCPS Employee Spotlight. I am happy to be within a department that promotes not only student wellness and well-being, but also engages and highlights employees and appreciates us. Well, I feel elated. I love being a part of Clayton County Public Schools, which is why I've been here for 9 years. For the foreseeable future, I will be here. I feel very elated and just thankful for this moment and opportunity for recognition.
My name is Regina Paget. I'm a Spanish teacher at Riverdale High School. I joined Clayton County Public School System in 2006. And I've been at Riverdale High School since 2006. I think anytime you're recognized for what you're so passionate about, it's an honor. But when your students actually notice and they want to recognize you, they not only recognize it, but they want everyone else to recognize it. You can't compare that. It's a wonderful honor. I would like to thank Latavia Anderson for recognizing me, for nominating me. Thank you so much.